Hello, friends, and welcome back to Stories About Entitled People. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you're new here and turn on notifications so you don't miss a new video every single day. Here we go. Don't steal from the same place twice. I used to work for this company about 3 years ago that was subcontracted out to a huge, huge manufacturing company. What we did was basically cook an enormous variety of meals for the employees there. We were a small company though, so I only ever worked with one other person during the shift catering to the workers. To give you an idea of the area, for story purposes, one side was basically a buffet line that I would dish their food on, the other side was a grill area for requests. In the middle was the register, and across from that was a huge array of drinks. Adjoined to the cafeteria area is the eating area, as well as an outside area. After working there for a good while, I began to recognize all of the faces and people. I worked second shift, so a lot less people would come in. One day, while working, I see this guy, let's call him John. I notice he grabs his food I prepared and walks over to get a drink and then walks away. He didn't pay for his food. I waited a bit, as sometimes more trusting employees will come back after eating to pay, or they forget and pay us the next day. We weren't lenient with nice people, but he didn't. The next day he comes back and I politely tell him he forgot to pay yesterday. He kind of fake laughs and said he wasn't paying attention and pays for yesterday and today's food. However, after paying for his food, I see him sit down, then come back and grab an energy drink and leave. He didn't pay for it. Now I'm kind of like, what? I wait again, but I have other people to serve, so I brush it off because I didn't know his name at the time to report it. 2 weeks pass. The main company employees work in rotating shifts, and I see him again. I don't mention the stolen drink, and he orders from the grill. The other person I worked with was this middle-aged lady with leukemia. We'll just call her Lady. She makes him his food, and I watch as he takes the food and leaves. I'm flabbergasted at this point. I mention to my coworker what just happened, and she says she'd seen him steal food and drinks on other shifts as well. We proceed to tell our boss the next day, and he tells us to deny him any food or services until he pays up. So, cue later that evening, me and her are working, and he goes up to the grill to order. She politely tells him that our boss has denied him services since he's been stealing and needs to pay first. At this point, I should add that calling the police couldn't be justified since we had no security cameras in this area, sadly. Now this infuriates John. He proceeded to start yelling at her, saying she doesn't know what she's talking about, to cook his food. She responds by saying she isn't allowed and to just pay. John states he isn't paying for anything since he didn't take anything, to which coworker responds that she watched him steal just yesterday. He gives her the bird and storms out of the cafeteria. For a while, we think that's the last of them, thankfully. I hated watching someone steal and be helpless to stop. I was only a 21-year-old girl at the time and very passive. However, about 3 weeks later, I see him lurking in the back and he'd been getting someone else to buy food for him. Watched as he passed money to someone else and they came up for food and passed it back to him. And then another 2 weeks after that, he came in and ordered food again. Me and Lady look at each other and just decide, you know, F it. Didn't really feel like bringing that crap up again as long as he didn't steal again. He didn't. For 2 whole days. Okay, so by this time, things are just getting ridiculous. Other of my coworkers from other shifts have reported this guy stealing as well, but our boss is too much of a bee to really do anything. Here comes the head. About a month after or so, can't remember specifically, and John has been stealing at least once a week, either food or drinks or both, I'm working with a different coworker at the moment, and I see John walk in. My heart is literally racing because I decide that if he steals something, I'm going to do something about it. I watched as he goes, grabs a drink, and takes it to the eating area. Although since a multitude of people were getting food, I wouldn't notice. He comes back up and gets his food to pay. I ring him up for not only his food, but a drink as well. He gets this disgusted look on his face and asks why the price is so high. I tell John that it's because I'm ringing him up for the food and the drink he took earlier. At this point, my heart is literally beating out of my chest. I've never confronted someone before. The following conversation then unfolded. I didn't take no damn drink. Sir, I saw you take it and place it back there. Well, you're mistaken, so take it off the price. No, I saw you take it, and everyone has seen you steal from us the past couple of months, and you're always stealing from us. At this point, my voice is wavering. At this point, John is yelling almost at the top of his lungs, Literally everyone in the cafeteria has stopped and are staring at us. You're a effing bee! I didn't take anything! Now you better take the price off! Me, looking at my male coworker, you saw him stealing when I did. Say something.
Can't you just pay for the drink if you took it?
John starts pointing at me and crap.
I'm not effing!
He then goes on to spiel a whole mess of curse words at me. At this point, I'm literally crying in front of what has to be about 50 people at the time, and I sob to my coworker to just handle this for me as I go to the back. I can hear John cursing at him too, and apparently he stormed off with his unpaid food. I come back out as I still have a job to do, and one of the employees who's always friendly with me is standing there and says, I saw the whole thing, and I've also seen him steal, and that's no way to talk to someone doing their job. I know his boss and will point him out when he comes in. So the guy's boss comes in about 20 minutes later, and both me, my coworker, and the employee tell him everything that has happened. He's stunned and consoles me and tells me that he's going to fix everything. Not even an hour later, I get word that John was immediately fired following a meeting about his behavior and had to be escorted out by security guards because he was violently cursing and making threats, including one about me. I was suggested to have someone walk me to my car for the next week, as apparently he had been driving around the parking lot looking for me. There's security to get on site and you need a pass. People were saying how he had 3 kids, so he was especially PO'd. It was wonderful after that, as I never had to worry about him again. I'm pretty sure he thought he could get away with it because it was mostly women in our subcontracted company, a whole like 10 of us, and figured we'd be too occupied with other hungry employees to notice him stealing right under us. I should add that the huge company that fired him, it's almost impossible to get a job there without knowing someone because it pays unbelievably well with mega benefits and all that. So losing that job is a big deal. And our next story. Don't yell at employees, then litter. My husband and I were at Starbucks, our usual Starbucks, getting our usual. It was busy, as it is at brunch time. We waited for a bit, no problem. This wild Karen appears, claiming there are too many people in the store and she wants her food now. This Starbucks also has a drive-thru. She's screaming at these teenagers about how they aren't in compliance and she's going to call the city about it. I screamed at her, you can always go through the drive-thru, but she didn't hear me. We left the store and ate in the car. 30 seconds later, Karen gets in her SUV and starts to take her gloves off and throw them on the ground of the parking lot. I see this and think, absolutely not. I got out of my car, picked up the gloves, and put them under her wiper blade as she was trying to back out. Take your crap with you, Karen. Not that anyone should be littering anyway, but during a pandemic isn't the time to make other people pick up your trash. And our last story. You're close with the boss? I am too. Back around 2000 to 2002, my dad and a friend started a company. They put in the grueling and overwhelming amount of work necessary for it to have grown exponentially over the past 20 years. A couple years ago, they had an opening for a technical editor, and my dad offered me the position. I'd just like to say that I am so unbelievably grateful for this, and always will be, and I'm very mindful of the fact that I have to tread lightly sometimes. Every year during the holiday season, they, like most businesses, throw a holiday party. They have several around the country, so every office has one, but the main one is where corporate is headquartered. The first year I attended the party, nobody knew who I was. I tend not to share who I'm related to, for obvious reasons, unless somebody asks. It's not a secret by any means, but it's not something I shout from the rooftops. Anyways, the bar opened an hour before the party technically started, and since it's an open bar, a few people were already quite a few drinks in. I went up to get a drink, and somebody, who I've never met, introduced himself to me in a pretty rude and arrogant way. I'm talking, you probably already know who I am, but if you don't, you should. I'm Holden, fake name. He was pretty clearly drunk, but it's a party and I didn't blame him. I shook his hand and tried to walk away, but he wouldn't stop talking about how important he was to the company. I smiled and nodded and awed for a while, even as he spilled his drinks on me from gesturing wildly. Eventually he told me, I'm also really close with the president. This interested me quite a bit because that was my dad and I'd literally never heard this person's name. Not a problem, though, because I didn't know all his friends, but this dude kept going. Here's how that conversation went. Him. Yeah, you can pretty much call his family friends. Me. Really? You know his family? Oh, yes, of course. We've gotten together a few times. His kids love me. wow, that's pretty cool. I wasn't planning on saying anything because he was drunk and it didn't really matter to me. However, he then turns around and says, okay, well, I have more interesting people to talk to now, and walked away. I was livid. First of all, you spilt your crappy, dirty martinis all over me, so I smell like olives. You were kind of a jerk from the get-go. You waste 30 minutes bragging about yourself, and then you tell me I'm uninteresting? So I waited until the perfect moment when the party had started to taper off a bit. Our homeboy Holden was still there, even more drunk than he was before. He eventually made his way over to my dad and mom, chatting them up and whatnot. I sidle over to the group and he gives me the stink eye, probably thinking I'm trying to cozy up to them too. The look of horror on his face when my dad hugs me and kisses me on the cheek and says, hey honey, your brother's coming to pick us up, do you need a ride? Was indescribable. It was a combination of, I think I just crapped my pants, and I'm going to yeet myself out this window immediately. It was genuinely one of the best small revenges of my life. Hey guys, thank you all for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one.